الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. The subject matter still is about the Qibla and the changing of the Qibla. And this is the first, according to the Mufassirin of the Qur'an, that this is the first act of abrogation, changing a legislation that was sent in the Qur'an by another legislation. And in this case, this is one of the greatest fitnas that the Muslims have faced because of three groups that were present in the Medina and in Mecca at the time. And these are the mushrikeen, the disbelievers, the mushrikeen, the people of the book in the Medina, and the hypocrites in the Medina. So here, the Prophet ﷺ, as we said, was eager to follow, just like he followed the millah of Ibrahim ﷺ, he was eager to follow the qibla of Ibrahim ﷺ. So these ayat, وَمِنْ حَيْثُ خَرَجْتَ فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. This same ayah, or this same command, was repeated three times. The Mufassirin said, because of the importance of the matter, and to affirm and confirm that this is beyond the shadow of a doubt that this is the Qibla of the Muslims. Some other interpreters said, no. The command is repeated three times, one for the people who are present in Mecca, one for the people who are present outside of Mecca, and one for the travelers. Whatever the case might be, collectively, this is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a command, this is a legislation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we as Muslims say, سَمْعًا وَطَاعًا, we hear and we obey. وَمِنْ حَيْثُ خَرَجْتَ فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ وَإِنَّهُ لَلْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. And wherever you may be, direct your face towards al-masjid al-haram as your qibla. And indeed, this is al-haq, meaning that lal-haq versus al-haq. Lal-haq means beyond the shadow of a doubt. Al-haq means the infinite truth or the truth. But lal-haq with the lam, it means beyond the shadow of a doubt. وَإِنَّهُ لَلْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. In this case, in the previous ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not oblivious of that or about that which they are doing, they're plotting, meaning that the people of the book, the mushriks, and the hypocrites. And that's an act of threat to them. But here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ, means that what you are doing. So therefore, observe him in every act of worship. Obey him in every command that he has, and practice proper etiquettes when it comes to supplicating and dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنْ حَيْثُ خَرَجْتَ فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ وَحَيْثُ مَا كُنْتُمْ فَوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ شَطْرَهُ. This third repetition, or this third ayah, that commands us to direct our faces towards the Qibla, specifically addresses the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَمِنْ حَيْثُ خَرَجْتَ, O Prophet of Allah, then direct your face towards Al-Qibla. And then it addresses us as Muslims, وَحَيْثُ مَا كُنْتُمْ, wherever you might be. And of course, the rule of thumb is, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا, that you endeavor to do your very best, whether you are traveling or you're praying in any part of the earth, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this earth a masjid, you know, for us. Wherever you might be, you do your very best to find where the Qibla is, and then you direct your salah towards Al-Qibla. وحيثما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطرة لئلا يكون للناس عليكم حجة. So that people will not have any come back at you by way of using some level of evidence. And the level of evidence that people of the book had is that they claimed, as the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم followed the initial Qibla, which is Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, which is their Qibla, that sooner or later he was going to also follow their Millah. And that's a false claim. That's a false anticipation. The mushrikeen in Mecca, they said, the Kaaba is the Qibla of, you know, Ibrahim alayhi salam. And therefore, he, you know, it's part of glorifying and honoring this Kaaba that the Muslims would direct their faces towards Al-Qibla. So these have some level of claim to make, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to set the record straight. And that's why he said, لِأَلَّا يَكُونَ لِلنَّاسِ عَلَيْكُمْ حُجَّةً. So no one would come back with an evidence and say, well, they're following our Qibla, so therefore, sooner or later, they're going to follow our Millah. Or, you know, they're not following the Qibla of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Because we are honoring this Qibla, so therefore we're closer to Ibrahim than this Prophet. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to set all of that aside. And for those who made the false claim, like the hypocrites, and they will make a claim just for the sake of making a claim, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them as the oppressors. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ. And those are the oppressors, which are the hypocrites, that they will make an argument no matter what. Whether the Qibla is towards Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa or Al-Masjid Al-Haram, they will make that claim no matter what. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ فَلَا تَخْشَوْهُمْ وَخْشَوْنِي. Do not fear them and fear me. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتِي عَلَيْكُمْ. In every act of legislation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتِي عَلَيْكُمْ. It's a perfection of the ni'mah, the infinite bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that He legislates more and more guidance for the believers. So the Qibla of Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa is the third most important and most sacred Qibla for the Muslims. Masjid for the Muslims. However, Al-Masjid Al-Haram is of greater value and greater sanctity and greater honor and greater status. So therefore, directing our faces from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa to Al-Masjid Al-Haram is indeed more the perfection of the bounty of the of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestowed upon us, which is the bounty of Islam. So it's more and more guidance under this umbrella of Islam. وَلِيُتِمَّ نِعْمَتِي عَلَيْكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. Indeed, the more legislation there is, the more guidance there is for the believers. So it's more likely that will be more and more guided. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ, so that you may be guided. كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ. Of course, the perfection of all of these bounties under the umbrella of Islam is the descendant of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ, the best of men to walk the face of the earth. أَنَا خَيْرُ بْنِ آدَمْ وَلَا فَخْرُ. I am the best of the children of Adam, and I am not saying this as a matter of arrogance, وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stating as a matter of fact, he is the best of the children of Adam to walk the face of the earth. كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ. And notice this, is as we mentioned before, this is the response to the supplication of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, when he said, رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِنْهُمْ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ. And it's further and further perfection of this ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this messenger came from within. He did not come from an outside tribe or an outside ummah. He came from within the ummah of La ilaha illallah, from the lineage and from the descendants of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا. Recite these ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ. When Ibrahim alayhi salam mentioned the dua, he mentioned the tazkiyah at the very end. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the very end of his dua, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ, means that this is really the most important thing. Is that as a result of all these vehicles of acts of worship, salah and siyam and zakah and hajj and dua and so on and so forth, the very purpose of that is what? Is to achieve the level of tazkiyah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sets as a criterion for those who are successful. When he says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا, that those will be successful at the end, not those who pray and fast and perform the hajj, but rather those who understand the mission and the ghaya, the objective behind all of these acts of worship, is that to achieve tazkiyah. And without achieving the tazkiyah, all of these acts of worship perhaps will not have any weight for them on Judgment Day. كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ. He teaches you how to achieve tazkiyah. He was the walking Quran. And he teaches you how to let go of lying and embrace honesty and integrity and belief. To let go of cowardness and to embrace courage and yaqeen, deep conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To let go of acts of shirk and disbelief and to embrace acts of iman and acts of gratitude and so on and so forth. كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. يُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابَ means to teach you the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To teach you the Qur'an by way of words and by way of setting a role model of himself. When Aisha radiallahu anha was asked about the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ.
His character was the Qur'an. And this is your mission and mine, is to come as close of a character, to adopt a character that is as consistent as possible with the Qur'an and the Sunnah. This is our mission. And of course, it's a very high ceiling. But this is, again, this is a mission, this is a ceiling for us, this is something for us to strive towards and to endeavor for. وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ وَيُعَلِّمْكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ الْحِكْمَةِ here, some of the scholars mention that is the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. As he says, خُذُوا مَنَاسِكَكُمْ عَنِّي take your acts of worship from me. Pray like you saw me pray, fast like you saw me fast, perform the pilgrimage like you saw me perform the pilgrimage, and other forms of ibadat and other ways of leading a moderate life in Islam. وَيُعَلِّمْكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ Some others said الْحِكْمَةِ as we mentioned before, فِعْلُ مَا يَنْبَغِي كَمَا يَنْبَغِي فِي الْوَقْتِ الَّذِي يَنْبَغِي Do what is asked of you, what is commanded of you, as you ought to perform it, according to the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, at the time that you ought to perform it. And that applies to the ibadat and to the mu'amalat and to everything else. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ And that he will teach you that which you did not know. Everything we know about Islam is by way of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So that's why the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would reap an equivalent ajr for every righteous deed that we perform with the purity of intention and the consistency of following the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he gets an equivalent reward because he's the master of all teachers. He's the shaykh of all shuyukh. He's the imam of all a'imma. So therefore, whatever the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us is what we follow. We don't follow shaykh so-and-so or shaykh so-and-so or scholar so-and-so if we find out that they've committed an error. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of them. But if we find out that they've committed an error, because he's my sheikh, it does not make him he's my leader. My leader is the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and if my sheikh errs, I am obligated to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ The peak of ibadah and the peak of shukr is to always keep your tongue moist with the remembrance of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And that's why he says, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي And be grateful to me. Doing dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an act of shukr, is an act of rendering gratitude. But here it's mentioned because the best of shukr is to keep your tongue and your heart and your mind always vigilant of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best form of dhikr, مَا تَوَاطَى عَلَيْهِ الْقَلْبُ وَاللِّسَانِ When the heart and the tongue are united and doing at the same time. In other words, it's not that someone is just basically making dhikr with their tongue, subhanAllah, subhanAllah, and they're giving it absolutely no attention. Or they're doing, you know, they're busy doing other things. Or they're engaged in some other activity and they're just basically, you know, uttering these words. No, the best of dhikr is for the heart and the tongue to be consistent in making this dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ Kufr can be the opposite of shukr. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us, as we know, to perform shukr. اِعْمَلُوا أَلَ دَاوُدَ شُكْرًا وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ So for the heart, there are acts of shukr. That is to always fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To love Him like you love no one else. To always be vigilant of Him. For the tongue is to be moist with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. التسبيح, التحميد, التهليل, الاستغفار, so on and so forth. All acts of and for the rest of the limbs to follow suit as well. Is to always be engaged in that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who often remember Him and to make us among those who are successful in rendering the due gratitude that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves. At least maybe we can come close to that. We will never be successful in rendering that true due gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهذا والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته